I am Dr. Santosh Kumar, Professor of Urology, PGI, Chandigarh. Prostate problems are very common. Among people above 45 years or even above 40, at least 50% have some kind of prostate problem. And in fact, 30% of the male population above 50 years of age have this issue. They keep taking some or the other medicine for prostate problems. And 40, 45, 50 years, that's not such an old age that one should give up on sex. Does the prostate affect one's sex life? The prostate does affect sex life, if well. If the prostate is enlarged, it affects sex life. Do prostate medicines affect sex life? Yes, prostate medicines also affect sex life. Some medicines have a greater effect, while some have a lesser effect. Today, we'll give you information about which medicines have a greater effect and which ones do not affect much. When the prostate gland becomes inflamed, it blocks the urinary passage and causes problems with urination, which can lead to infection. You may have to urinate frequently. You may have to get up frequently at night to urinate. There can be an infection in the urine, and it can also affect the kidneys. If PSA levels are also elevated, then it could even be prostate cancer. So always get prostate treatment done by a urologist and make sure to get a PSA test before starting treatment. This is the urinary bladder and this is the urinary passage. This is the prostate. When the size of the prostate gland increases, sometimes even due to the increased size, it can cause obstruction. And there are glands present in the prostate as well. Along with that, there are some muscles which compress the passage. So, two types of medicines are given for this. One is to reduce the size of the prostate and the other is to relax the prostate so that urination becomes easier. So, the medicines that are given are of two types. The third treatment for the prostate is surgery done through an endoscope. Whether it's prostate medicine or surgery through endoscopy, both can affect your sex life. Your sex life can become dry and ejaculation may not happen. The ejaculation that happens goes into the blood. Then the semen comes out again with the urine. One, the medicine that is given, see, this is the normal size of the prostate and this is how it looks when the prostate has enlarged. So the medicine given to reduce the size is called dutasteride or finasteride. Any medicine you take for this will have a D or an F in its name. This means it contains dutasteride or finasteride. These reduce the effect of sex hormones and also decrease the size of the prostate. When the effect of sex hormones is reduced, there can be sexual problems, but the size of the prostate will also decrease. But you have to take this medicine for quite a long time. 10 days, 20 days, 2 months, 4 months. Taking prostate medicine does not reduce the size of the prostate. To reduce the size of the prostate, the dutasteride or finasteride medicines that are taken have to be taken for years. The other medicine is silodosin or Tamsulosin. These relax the passage of urine, so the bladder, the neck of the bladder, like this is the bladder and this is the prostate. So the semen, which should come forward, goes backward into the bladder, and that's what causes retrograde ejaculation. This happens a lot with silodosin and Tamsulosin. Alright, but there is one medicine. The one that comes by the name alfuzosin, it has this side effect less. The medicines like finasteride and dutasteride, they kill the sex drive. They can increase impotence and reduce interest in sex. When these prostate medicines are given to people aged 40, 45, 50, 55 for a long time, it affects their sex life. But if you don't want to go for surgery, there are medical options, And among the medical options, if you want to reduce the size, then dutasteride has to be given. It's called a DHT blocker and the other is called an alpha blocker. Alpha blocker opens up the passage. Look, this is the prostate. Here it has been relaxed. So what should come out during sex sometimes goes back into the bladder. So sometimes the partner doesn't feel satisfied. So this happens because of alpha blockers like psilocin and tamsulosin. If you have to give tamsulosin or psilocin, it should be given to people above 55 or 60 years of age. Because retrograde ejaculation and dry sex happen due to this. Tamsulosin and psilocin can be the reason for dry sex. Alfazosin, which is another medicine, has this issue to a lesser extent. And when surgery is done through endoscopy, the prostate is cut away. In this way, we open up the passage for the flow of urine. So the semen that comes out goes backwards. So the surgery of the prostate, whether it's laser surgery or TURP, which is the standard surgery, it can cause dry sex and even impotence. If you are a relatively young individual and genuinely want to keep your intimate sex life completely normal and healthy, then the new treatment, which is UroLift, compresses the prostate a bit, moves it to the side and opens up the passage. This is UroLift, but this is an expensive treatment. Also, it is not useful for prostates larger than 45 or 50 grams. This is my own experience. The company recommends it up to 80 grams. But my experience with UroLift is bossne. No one should have any objection to this. It is effective for prostates smaller than 45 or 50 grams. There is less chance of retrograde ejaculation with this. Zero is nothing at all. This is for heart patients, liver patients, kidney patients, and those with breathing problems. For those who have many other problems, UroLift is also a beneficial option. And it is also a good option for those who are taking blood thinners. So the treatment of prostate gland, the treatment of prostate problems can also be done without any hassle. Prostate surgery can cause dry sex and prostate medicines can also cause dry sex. Which medicine to take, when to take it, how to modify it, and how to keep a normal sex life intact. Keep it alive, and there is a new option called UroLift. You can try that as well. This is a costly option. It is not for very large prostates, and it can last for 10 years, possibly improving your sex life. Some medicines along with alpha blockers also include sex-related medicines so that your sex life remains intact. But these can be added with alpha blockers, not with dutasteride. Dutasteride or finasteride is used to reduce the size. So if you are taking that medicine, you can add the sex-related medicine along with the alpha blocker. If you want to keep your sex life intact, you must ask your urologist that you are sexually active and want to keep your sex life intact. Ask them to give you a better alternative. There is no need to be scared or embarrassed. What is the quality of your life? What are you interested in? Be sure to inform your urologist and along with keeping your urination normal, also keep your sex life normal. This UroLift that I mentioned, if you consider it, has zero sexual side effects. But I don't agree. In 95% of cases, it can have zero sexual side effects. But in 5% of those 95% cases, side effects can occur. But those who want to remain sexually active can try this. Thank you. This was our short video in which we discussed how increasing age and an enlarged prostate as well as its treatment, affect sex life and how to preserve your sex life. Thank you.